Right, I've imported those tunes into the editor. Just turn the telly down a bit. I've created sound cues from them. What? Sorry, I was just in Unity checking on something there. Just double check something here quick. I'm just gonna start my task manager quickly, make sure that server is still is not trying to access my computer. Oh, what is that running for? I've got so many millions of processes running here that even though I've got a lot of memory and a big chip and a good graphics card, I don't like these things. Look at that swarm agent, nothing's even running and it's on 22 meg. Yeah, don't lose the thread here. Right, okay. So, sounds. Right, what I've done is I've put one of them in the menu now so that when I go into the second part. In fact, I need to change the main game theme as well because it's that Dr. Dre one still. So I'm going to go. Oh, yeah, and I bunged a tree in the map as well because I wasn't sure if speed tree trees would work okay. Looks a bit funky, the colour, doesn't it? It looks alright when you go in the editor, though, as far as I remember. Let's have a quick look. I know, because we've got to run through all the game and that. I think this is just the preview. Looks a bit strange. But if not, I'll adjust the colours on it. So, yeah, you can put speed tree in speed trees in your mobile game. I've also got a standalone of speed tree now as well. I don't just use the one that's included in the UDK documents. I'll show you that quick. No, it's not there. Where is it? Where's it gone? Oh, can't work. I can't remember where I put it. It should be in my documents. There it is. Yeah, I'm going to put it in here, it's easier to find then. So you can just start it up without actually having UDK running. Well, you can anyway with the UDK one, but this is easier this way. And it doesn't install itself on your computer. There you go, speed tree. So, I've put a tree in the editor now and it looks a bit funny, the colour does, but I think it looked fine when I went in playing. And I've got the character harming bots now as well as them harming me. I say bots, I mean dragons. So it's time really to make a good map. Because so far in this series all I've done is created all these silly test maps everywhere. And I put my castle there, my orange sort of cartoony castle. That looks a bit messed up, doesn't it? But it'll do. It was just to give the illusion of something being there rather than just a flat slab of nothing. So anyway, dragons are working and I think I ran over how I did it in the last video. Basically, what I've done in my version of the Jazz minimap as well is I've just got one bot sequence here. Now that is it. Fairly simple. Spawning. Attached to event. Why have I got bite when close? Ah, I know why. Because this is my alternative Dragonville map and I hadn't changed the names over. That should say burn when close. Dragon. I'm starving as well. I've got to have some dinner in a little while. Been working on the computer all day creating tunes and that and working on this map and then with the hundreds of emails I get sending people stuff to help them. Dragon, yep. Change the name of that one now. Burnwin. Close. Yep, sorted. And then what else? Die, yeah, he dies. When we shoot him now. I think I've set it up right. Anyway, he dies anyway when I shoot him. So, this is the Dr. Dre tune that I want to now change for one of my own homemade tunes. So, we'll go back, scroll back through the content browser. Let's see which one. Yeah, that'll do. Nice fast pace. So, kismet. Oh, what was the tune? I can't remember. It will have the name anyway when it comes up. So, 03. Just change that comment. 03Q. That way I know what where I am with everything. And now that's referenced in a couple of other places, that tune, the Dr. Dre one. What's that say? Oh, audio. Oh no, this is just the taunts. You know where he goes, "Ow, that hurts," and then, "Come on, let's kill some dragons." Right, the tune is played over here somewhere. 03Q. Oh no, I didn't want it in this one that I've just done. I wanted that to be a different tune because I've got that as my menu cue, that one. So we're going to find a different one quick. So where's my first one? So that's, I think, what we'll have temporarily as the game sound at the moment. O1Q, right, okay. Sorted. I think that's referenced one more place. So on a restart somewhere. 03Q, that's the menu one there. On level load up, is it? Let's scroll out, I can't see where I am here. There it is. Change its name. Much easier having these simple little numbers as names. There we go. Right. Nice and neat. Let's have a quick play. Might be a bit loud, so I might have to turn the chat sound down. There you go. No copyright on that track.
Let's kill some.
Crappy score. I don't know if you noticed that the fire effect is sort of taking over a bit too much. I've got to decrease the particle size, and I don't know why they're spawning both together in, you know, two at a time. I've got them set down to singular spawn. It's the only thing I've got to address at the moment. Excuse me, and then it's time to make the big map, you know. Get this so spawn rate 1, maximum allowed agents 700, clear old archetypes. Before we do that, let's go save. I'll set myself in a good position. So did you notice here, yeah, that tree is all pink and funny looking actually. It might just be my lighting being a bit too harsh. I think I've got too many lights in here. How many have I got? I'm going to turn the lights down actually. Make it a bit darker. So before I do this, let's do the lighting before I save. Well, no, always wise to save and then save again. Right, so find the lights. Scene. Right, what lights have we got? A pre-computed visibility volume. Directional light. I've got two of them, so select both of them. Hopefully they're now selected. Nope. Oh, we're going to have to click on one. They're both next to each other anyway, so easy to find. Because if you click on it, they're in the scene there. It will take you straight to it. So, right, double click it. There we go. So, let's select both of them. Right click, directional light properties. Light component. Now, what we want is light component. That's what we want actually. It should be anyway. Advanced lighting. Cast shadows, yeah, cast static shadows, whatever. Light shafts, this has changed. There used to be a one where you could change the brightness. Ah, because I've got two lights selected, yeah, it's not the same. 1.5, way too much. So we're going to set that to 1. And now we're going to select that one on its own, which was blue. Now I'm going to change the colour to sort of greeny colour. Or maybe reddy colour. Oh, it's updating. Oh yeah, that purpley colour looks good. So we go OK with that one. And then the other light, which is white or pink, we're going to change that to greeny colour. hopefully that might give my tree a better appearance. Right, shut that down for a minute, let's have a look. It has actually, hasn't it? Yeah, it looks more green. So we go back over here, save ourselves in that position. I'll now rebuild the lighting and paths and whatnot. So I want the tree in view as I save it as well. So build all. I'll save before I do it, then save again after, just in case it crashes. Although, I must say, I've only had two crashes since I've had this editor, and that was where I was really putting it through its paces. So yeah, basically the old dragons, they have an anim notify in their animations. I'll run through that in a minute when this is done. Which is how I'm killing them. Although I still can't work out how my gun is affecting them. It's not as obvious as in when you set up a normal shooting game in the PC editor. You know, because your gun has got a damage type associated with it. I can't work out how this one works. Although what it might be, oh no, it's gone all bright again. What is occurring there? Where's them lights gone again? Yeah, that's far too bright. I'm gonna get rid of one of them lights. Dynamic light, whichever, and then go delete, or directional light I should say. Let's make sure there are no others in there, because it looks ridiculously bright. So this one now, I'm going to now drop the light down of that. Let's make sure there are no skylights in there, that could be it. Lens flare. I don't remember putting a lens flare in there. That could be connected with my particles. I'll worry about that later. Right, so this one, drop its properties right down. No. Did I select a brush? Sorry, I'm just having a go at the editor. So I'll do that at point 6. Oh, it's probably going to be too dark now. We'll come out, yeah, sort of in between green and yellow, the colour. Right. Yeah, I don't really need it that bright. Right. Tree's looking good anyway, until we build the lighting again. So we'll just build the lighting this time, don't need to build the paths. See how that goes. And then in the next tutorial, it's time to create the map and put all this stuff in it that works. I'll try and work the dragon out to stop it spawning on top of itself. God, what is the matter with this thing? Surely there's something here that's not right.